excited. One, because there's nothing much going to happen this weekend. There's no formal party, Simanya, the black and green party, the purple green party. There's nothing to look forward to. And for a girl of my stature, that is one of the things I look forward to. The fact where I can sit at home and not think that, hey, mama, people are out having a blast. So, yeah, welcome to Scoop and Scoop. It's a Friday edition. It's been a very long, long week. Need I say that again? But hey, let's get what's happening in Celebville, and especially today. I think today I'm just going to dedicate this day to people who I can't say we say ill about them. They brought it upon themselves. But hey, let's just talk about whatever it is that is there. So, I think today, let me start off by saying this. Muveku Vincent Musisi, mumureke, mumureke. I know, coming from me, it's weird, but have you guys thought about it? Every time I open up a newspaper or read a tabloid and everybody's saying, Vince and Karungi, they broke up. Vince did this. Vince slept with this one. Vince messed up the marriage. Vince did this. I am tired. It's not fair. You see, let me tell you one thing about Vince. Vince ainechi zibuchimu. Vince cannot keep what's in his pants, inside his pants. He just has, I didn't get it, I got a chidara, sakatu jasa wabina. Aba yagala agenda funeyo chafunyem. But have all of us looked at the fact that, why is it that every time somebody writing about this story always has to put Vincent as the bad guy? Let's just take the light away from him. Let's look at, just a minute. Let's look at Josephine Karungi. Zabwendaba Karungi, honestly speaking, I don't think waliwe mkazi asobola okulema okubera ne Vince. I'm just saying, yes, one, he's a party animal. Two, he's a huge slip around. Three, isn't that just it? I think those are the bad things about Vincent. Like, for real, those are the only bad things. Ne? Omukasi wole merit what to be with such a guy. And honestly speaking, I think Vince is one of those quiet guys, like, before he drinks. Like, you find him and he's there like, hello, hi. Hi. Karungi, on the other hand, is one of those pretty girls, smiley girls. Like, she's Mrs. Goody Two Shoes. She sits like this because she knows with her look and with the job that she does, everybody's going to come running to her aid. They're all going to side with her. But, walai, I know everyone who writes stories about Vince will write a wrong story. But the reason why they write bad stories about Vincent is one, simply one reason. Vincent has banged too many media personalities, too many media people in media houses. He has banged way too many at every media house. He has banged a certain girl, so they all have a vendetta. So whenever something is supposed to be written about Vince, they're like, come away. These are confessions of, very huge confessions of girls who have been banged and left there. So why do we look at Vincent and say he's bad? What, because he sleeps around? It's not a good thing, for real, it isn't. But there are men out there who still do it. And yeah, we're not putting them on a cross like we are him. Secondly, I don't think Josephine Karungi is such a saint like we paint her for. No, I don't think she's a patient. She's not the... Omanyobo because we sanga ku church, ngabo msanga tu devanaye ku church kerezia, nga she's all like, mwasebe mtia. Until you go live with her and you find out she's a nightmare. That's what I think is wrong with this chick. I think, buno bufumbo Vincent siye abumenya. Karungi ya kwato bufumbo na abumenya, she was too much. Don't sit home. Don't run this. Don't talk to this. Don't do this. And eventually, a guy who's been used to his freedom at the age of 35, 34, a man is just at his prime. He just wants to go out, have a blast with his boys, and come back home. Because I don't think Vince is the type of guy who goes out and drinks for nights on end and forgets to come back home. No. At the end of the day, for Joseph and always sit there and agamba, Vince mwenzi, church, and nemeso abufumbo. Ah, tegwe. The only thing that I'm loving about Vince is that he is a mature adult. He understands marriages are not supposed to be smooth sailing. They have rocky edges to them. Thorns and roses come together. So he is keeping quiet. Because by the time a man can hear rumors that the child she carried for him is actually not his, I'm also starting to believe it. I don't think that kid is Vince's kid. But he's quiet. He's keeping quiet. She's shouting for ashes. It's been like 2-3 years. The marriage ended. She's still there. Vince Mwenzi. Let me ask you, honey boo. When you were going to marry Vince, I bet you there was like a kakwanjuleka, baitakoba singa, nebatula, mama oyariwo, and they probably sat down and they were like, well, look here, girl, this is Africa. Our men are like A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Bwakukola E, kola D, bwakukola D, kola A. They didn't give you that talk because From what I remember, the few kwanjulas I've attended, especially the night sessions, the singers are like, bane msaja wagamba mwenzi, gwe sirika, yuwa mazimu kamwa mirada, yofumbe, nonya chaya gala chagenda na nonye bweru. But I don't think this is what this girl wanted. And I think when Vince got into this relationship, he was expecting something else, and he got way, way less. Every time you'd see Vincent out in a bar in the dead of the night, Josephine wouldn't be with him. And then you complain that guy mwezi. You let a man go to Cayenne. Have you seen the beautiful girls around Cayenne and how they dress up? So you let your very good looking 35-year-old man who has money to his name and a good career with all these vultures in Kampala walking around, sashaying, looking for a man to marry. You let him go out alone? Are you crazy? Miss Uganda is back, ladies and gentlemen. It is so, so back. There were auditions, the girls came through, and I sat there, I was like, so Miss Uganda is coming back. Let me see, what have all the previous Miss Ugandans done for us? Well, they have gone to cow farms, they have raised awareness on things that we pretty much know, condom use, farming, getting jobs. They're the pretty girls who wear a lot of makeup and acrylic nails and go show us they're trying to be in an NGO spirit. Those kind of girls. But my question was, I walk down the streets of Kampala every day. Every day I walk down these streets. And the first thing that always catches my attention is how bubbly Ugandan chicks are. This one, I will not lie. Ugandan girls have big butts. Ugandan girls have big hips. Ugandan girls want to be curvaceous all round. So my question was, when I saw all the girls who are walking in and out of the Miss Uganda audition, where are these girls? And who the hell told everyone on the planet that only skinny girls get to be Miss Uganda? Then someone was like, you know, you need to understand, Tina. We're supposed to get somebody who is a certain size so that they can represent us at Miss Universe. That is when I was like, you know what, you know, Chitade, we are still having dreams and hopes that we can ever win Miss Universe. Are you kidding me? Have you seen the Colombians? Have you seen the Indians? Have you seen the Peruvians? Have you seen the Americans, for crying out loud? And you're also sending our Lia Kalanguka to go and compete? Really? I just thought, let me first calm down. I thought the reason why we call her Miss Uganda is because she is supposed to embody the spirit of Uganda. She is supposed to be Ugandan. She's supposed to bring everything Ugandan to the forefront. She's supposed to be the mother of Uganda. Like when they say that chick is Ugandan, you're like, damn straight. She actually looks like the people back home. Y'all is bringing us skinny girls, and I don't have problems with skinny girls because I'm a chubby girl. No, I have me some skinny girl friends. Have you seen Amelia Mathanach team? Well, she's tiny, but she's my friend. I don't have a problem with them. But why are you bringing us girls who just do not sell us back home? Because when the Indians bring a girl for Miss Universe, she is Indian as hell. You are bringing us something that we do not understand. Get us some bubbly, curvy girls for Miss Uganda. Because if you're still living for the dream that you're taking her to Miss Universe, we shall never win that ish. Come rain, come shine. It's not meant for us. We just broke a 38-year curse in soccer. And you think, when are we going to break our curse in Miss Universe? Just get us someone who is going to do our work for us and represent us here. Not for the white man, no, for the Ugandans. So all you big chubby girls out there, or all you curvaceous, well put together girls, take your time out. Go and sit in these offices and tell them, Tamuja Tumanira. Even the Brazilians realized that they couldn't put skinny pencil thin models on air anymore. So they decided to get them bigger and better. That's why they invented a plus size. Not that every Ugandan girl is plus size. But one thing I know about Ugandan girls, they have curves. So we need to embody that. I'm just saying. And then as I was still going through that and very pissed, I had Anita Fabiola as a judge. So the judge of Miss Uganda is actually, she embodies Uganda. She has a bad hips, which she didn't have when she was running for Miss Uganda. But when she came out, she realized you need to get all this ish. And you still can't get the picture here? Come on now, what's her name, Brenda who? If we're getting Miss Uganda, let it be Miss Uganda. Let her embody Uganda the way it's supposed to be. Ebya Miss Universe mbiveyo, kote mgenda biwangula. Neyo muna akola chimu kama nebwa na jana atula wano. Aba wala bafete babi sobola, just by na malo. Period. Ew! It's been a beautiful week. My name is Tina. You know what to do. @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. Or you can get me on Facebook. That's, of course, the Scoop on Scoop Facebook page. Don't forget to like the page first. And the Urban TV Facebook page. For now, I'm out. Peace.